Last video, I said how painful it is. You have just bought a new home, but have yet no electricity. Unfortunately, this is happening more and more in new residential areas. Is it acceptable that you have to wait for months after getting the new keys? No. Let's explore three solutions to resolve this issue quickly. We'll start simply and build up to more advanced solutions. That's how I feel your love. Hi, Norbert here, energy engineer, and explaining in video number 74 how to bring electricity into your new dark home and possibly grow into a situation of complete independency from the grid. It's clear the electrical grid doesn't keep up with the growing electricity demand. In the meantime, you have to cook, heat the home, clean, work, and enjoy free time. So, what can we do about it? The first thing is to calculate how much energy you really need. Fortunately, many devices like lighting, the refrigerator, computers, telephone chargers, and television don't take very much power. Energy saving will help you to make the following solutions less expensive. Solution number one. The first simplest solution is to use an off-grid energy system, such as a portable power station or PPS with battery and inverter in one box to obtain AC grid voltage. I have here a small EcoFlow. There are also larger models, which are better for our situation of a complete home. They store electric energy from solar panels or other sources, and then you can have later electricity at normal grid voltage. There's no problem to connect a large unit just to your central home location. Then you have electricity in your whole house without cables everywhere. The cost of a power station from 300 euros to 3000, depending on the capacity. And you need to calculate how much kilowatt hours you need in one day. And that is energy. And you need also to know how many kilowatts you need maximum. And that is power. Please keep energy, which is a commodity, apart from power, which is the speed of delivery of energy. An example. This small EcoFlow can give about 500 watts for a short time. That is its maximum power, so the speed of energy flow. That is to keep the power below 250 watts on the long run, and then it is empty in 1 hour. Indeed, 1/4 of a kilowatt hour is its capacity or maximum stored energy. It's like a car. How fast can it go on the highway? And then you compare with power. And how far it can go with one full tank. And that you can compare with energy. You must know both for your house. A typical value for maximum power in a house in Italy is at 3.5 kilowatts. With electrical cooking, heat pumps, and charging electric vehicles, the values are much higher. And here we have the source of the problem. Why we are in this situation, also outside the Netherlands. The other value you must know for your house is the energy per day. That's a bit under 10 kilowatt hour for a normal household before the era of strong electrification with electric cooking, air conditioning, heat pumps, and electric vehicles. In video 43C, you see how I easily monitor energy and power for 35 euros with a meter in the whole house. And that is inspired by a social experiment in Amsterdam. Now your legitimate question is how to charge this without connection to your house. In the playlist Blackout and Security of Energy Supply, for example video 22A and B, prepared for a blackout, and the two videos number 10, review of a charge controller, I tell how to charge this power bank with solar energy. And in the last video of last Wednesday, number 73, I announced unconventional solutions for unacceptable situations. One of them is to lay an electric cable between your house and that of the neighbor. That's uncommon because, well, you understand it. Moreover, it's not allowed, or at least regulated, to sell energy to your neighbors in most legislations. Or at least there are rules. You must be aware of that before you roll out the cable in your garden. Otherwise, and if your neighbor is not in the same situation as you, because maybe the whole neighborhood is off the grid and without connection, then you can make a deal. The neighbor delivers you energy during off-peak hours when he doesn't need it, and that's also good for society, and can even use a timer switch, for example, for 15 euros. An energy meter of 30 euros can be at both ends of the cable, so that you can both check how much energy is flowing. Then you pay the full price and the neighbor has its off-grid discount, and you can take them out for a pizza. In case of restrictive regulations, you can bring the portable power station next door every day. You can just say, well, it's not about energy, it's a new model of a coffee machine. Sorry, energy is essential. You have to defend your essential rights and needs. Or you can also bring your portable power, your PPS, to another place to charge. Try to do that at off-peak hours. At least you contribute to the grid stability. Maybe the employer can show goodwill and buy a number of those batteries, charge them during the night, and lend them to employees that need it. That is energy solidarity. Finally, you can use your daily commute in a car to charge your battery with a 12-volt outlet that every car has. I tried it with our car. It gives 100 watts to my small PPS. So that means 1 hour commuting, for example, half an hour go and return, gives you then enough electricity for 3 hours computer use. Usually you have 10 or 15 ampere fuse on this power outlet, so a bigger and stronger PPS might be charged with up to 180 watts. If that is too slow and your PPS is strong enough, a do-it-yourselfer can think of making a direct connection to the car battery and, of course, with a fuse. MyVictor Multiplus is the second solution. Watch video number 43B, the Victor Multiplus charger inverter review 2024, if you want a solution that will remain in place and has not to be mobile. That might be a good idea, because also the net operators themselves foresee continuing quick growth of the demand and difficulties to keep its pace. Before we go to the last solution, here an invitation to do your part in the energy transition. The world is becoming a crowded place, with energy prices rising, grid reliability in question, and climate challenges growing every year. It's no longer enough to sit back and wait for solutions to come from above. We must come together, share knowledge, and take action ourselves. By joining this community, you are not just subscribing to a channel. You are stepping into a movement where we learn from each other, build do-it-yourself solutions, and take control over our energy future. Together we can create homes and systems that are resilient, sustainable and affordable. Memberships are now available. See the join button, offering deeper access to exclusive insights and innovations. Your support ensures that knowledge keeps flowing, empowering more people around the world to thrive in uncertain times. When I was inviting you in previous videos to express your interest in Q&A sessions, I was talking about this membership. You can cancel anytime. So, let's build a better, smarter energy future together. Subscribe now, become a member if you can, and let's inspire change. One idea, one home, one community at a time. Now, as promised, the third solution. It's a temporary generator. This solution is less sustainable. It's a gasoline generator. You can purchase a 2 kW generator for about 400 euros, which is enough to charge a not too small battery pretty fast. What bothers me is to see street markets with such a strong generator for each stand and 7 LED lamps for each of them. That is overkill. Also in your house, it is overkill if on some moment only the television, the refrigerator and a few lamps are working. Better is to limit the noise of the generator to a couple of hours. Keep the generator at its nominal power and charge the battery quickly in a couple of hours. So this battery has at least a few kilowatt hours. And that will power the house for the remaining part of the 24 hours. I am sorry to propose a fossil fuel solution, but we can make it very efficient. Again, with an uncommon solution. I don't see this idea on YouTube. Especially in the winter, it's very interesting to use the waste heat of this generator to heat the house. It's about 2/3 of the energy that is in the gasoline that you waste otherwise. You pay it and you don't use it. And only 1/3 of this chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. Okay, it's quite an ambitious goal for a do-it-yourselfer to make the conversion of a simple gasoline generator to a CHP unit, that is combined heat and power. Water-cooled gasoline or diesel generators would be better. They give you hot water at the right temperature that you can flow through your radiators. But they are many thousands of euros, about 10 times as those 400 euros. And they have also a large electrical power that you don't need. Air-cooled generators are much more affordable, as you saw before. But how do we recover this heat? This is an idea for a new video, and I want to test it before promising great results. In the case of a whole residential area, I would expect that the municipality or the project developer gives a helping hand. Instead of forcing everybody to find their own way, a shared solution can be more efficient, easy, and less noisy. A central diesel generator or a big container with batteries with a smart grid can provide electricity to all houses of the residential area. This battery container can be charged with off-peak power. This is attractive for the power supplier to make the grid more stable. They can give a constant 500 watts to each house, and that's 12 kilowatt hours per day. And each house has its own battery. That's only a few percent additional investment on each house. That has the additional benefit that the new residential area is very well prepared for the future and contributes less to the problem that caused the dark houses in the first place. Many new inhabitants will gravitate automatically towards complete off-grid living. Less stress on the grid, everybody is happy. So if you are dealing with delays in your power connection or live in a remote area, there are several solutions to have still power and even heat. From simple power banks to smart combinations of power banks, batteries, generators, and even heat pumps, the future of energy supply is more flexible than ever. Let's embrace this creativity, because ultimately it can help us to become more independent from the regular grid. I think that education in do-it-yourself can be very useful in these times, when it seems that we are too many, and too, if we don't change. Want to learn more about do-it-yourself energy management solutions? Then subscribe and consider also a membership. The advanced version gives access to a Q&A with a 3-decade energy engineer and divided in several language groups. I will soon make a video to explain this. I hope to see you in the next video.